The Narandari Dreaming. The story begins where the wide River Darling joins the River Murray. Narandari was travelling down the Murray River in a bark canoe, looking for his two wives who had run away after a quarrel. One day, when he was fishing from a bark canoe, Narandari saw Pondi, the giant Murray cod. He tried to spear the huge fish, but it quickly swam away downstream. When the giant cod reached the Murray, which was then just a small creek, it had nowhere to swim, so it went ploughing and crashing through the bush, making the creek into the mighty Murray River. Narandari chased the fish south into the land of the Narangeri. On and on it ploughed, forming the bends, cliffs and billabongs with its mighty tail. Near Murray Bridge he threw a spear, but missed, and the spear changed into Long Island. Near Talem Bend, he speared Pondi and caused it to surge ahead at extreme speeds and create a long straight stretch in the river until it finally escaped into Lake Alexandrina. Narandari rested near Wellington and sent a smoke signal to his brother-in-law, Nepali, who lived in Rauken. At last, with the help of Nepali, the wounded and weakened Pondi was speared as it swam by a Nepali's canoe. They both cut Pondi up into many pieces. Narandari threw each piece into the water and told it to become a new fish. Narandari created all the freshwater and saltwater fish of the Narangeri. Narandari left Rauken and made two huts where Mount Misery is and rested there. He changed some people who were trying to hide from him into blue fairy wrens of the lignum bush that live in the reeds. One night, he smelt bony brim cooking. This fish was forbidden to Narangeri women. He knew it was from the camp of his wives and it made him angry. He decided to leave his camp and find them. His two huts became two hills. Standing on the hills, he placed his bark canoe into the dark night sky where it became the Milky Way. Hearing Narandari coming, his wives just had time to build a raft of reeds and grass trees and to escape across Lake Albert. On the other side, their raft turned back into the reeds and grass trees. The woman fled along the Coorong, heading south. Narandari followed, but met a man called Parampari, close to Kingston. Parampari was a great evil sorcerer, a malignant spirit. "Have you seen my two wives walking?" Narandari asked him. Parampari started to quarrel and fight with Narandari. The two men fought with spears, clubs and magic forces until eventually Narandari won by killing Parampari with his club. He burnt Parampari's body in a huge fire to destroy the magic spell that made himself walk in a single place and never reach anywhere. The area of the fire changed into huge granite boulders. During the extraordinary battle, Narandari's wives had slipped past them unnoticed and fled back along the Coorong towards Encounter Bay. Narandari noticed and followed their footprints north through the sand hills of Coorong. Here he camped several times, digging soaks in the sand for fresh water and fishing in the Coorong Lagoon. Having lost the trail, Narandari made his way across the Murray Mouth and along the Encounter Bay towards Victor Harbour. He made a fishing ground at Middleton by throwing a huge tree into the sea to make a seaweed bed that trapped fish. At Port Elliot, his fishing net became the strange rocks of Pullen Island. At Victor Harbour, he made islands by throwing spears into the sea. Finally, after resting in a giant granite shade shelter on Granite Island for several days, Narandari heard his wives laughing and playing in the water near King's Beach. He threw his club to the ground, creating the headland called the Bluff at Victor Harbour, and chased after them. The women fled along the coast towards Cape Jervis. Narandari called out to them to stop. At this time, Kangaroo Island was still connected to the mainland, and the two women began to hurry across the shallow water to it. Standing high on the cliffs, he called out in a voice of thunder for the seas to rise. The women were swept from their path by huge waves and fought the water until they could swim no more. Their bodies and belongings became the Page's Islands. He crossed to Kangaroo Island, where he made a huge swamp oak tree to rest under. But the sound of the wind through the trees caused him to mourn his wives. Narandari then knew that it was time for him to leave this world. He went to the far end of the island, and after first throwing his spears into the sea, he dived deep into the sea to prepare his spirit. After becoming fully cleansed, he left the water and entered into the spirit world. He can be seen there today as a bright star in the Milky Way.